The LG G5 is arguably one of the most exciting phones of 2016, and it's absolutely dripping with potential thanks to a funky modular design. We're going to see what it's capable of in our full review. LG always seems to be fighting a battle when it comes to justifying phone design, but I love how it has the balls to be different. For example, with its rear-mounted smartphone buttons, which have survived in part for the G5. This is LG's first flagship to rock an aluminium body. But several critics are in a flap after one YouTuber claimed that it's actually part plastic, making reference to the phone's primer used to bond the paint to the metal frame. Thankfully, the G5 still looks and feels reassuringly premium, putting to bed the plastic fantastic demons of LG's past. At 5.3 inches, the G5 sports a more compact body than last year's G4, although it's also quite a chunky chap thanks to that modular functionality. One-handed use is also just about workable, mostly thanks to the option of a shortcut button to drop down the notifications bar. The power switch is again housed on the back, and this time it doubles as an accurate and responsive fingerprint sensor. However, the volume buttons have shifted to the side for the first time in years, which LG tells us is to keep the rear surface smooth and flat. So far, the G5 feels suitably rugged and seems to be putting up with plenty of abuse, with no signs of wear and tear. However, there's no signs of water resistance beyond general splash proofing, so if you do want to use a phone in the bath, it's best to opt for the Samsung Galaxy S7 or the Sony Xperia Z5. LG was a pioneer when it came to quad HD mobile displays, and the G5's 5.3 inch panel is another winner. High def images look fantastic, with incredible amounts of detail on display. You can't play with colour warmth like you can on some rivals, but the G5's palette is still pleasing to the eye and contrast levels are strong. The G5 screen also appears to be a little more powerful than the G4's on maximum brightness, so you won't have to squint when you're using it out in the sun. Sadly, the G5 doesn't boast in-your-face audio, but the tiny speaker hidden on the bottom edge does a decent job with music and videos. There's no real bass or body to speak of, but the G5's audio is nice and clear, and even at top volume, it doesn't distort. And if you prefer to carry around your media collection rather than streaming it, the good news is that the 32GB of onboard storage can be quickly and easily expanded using a microSD memory card. LG's own UX 5.0 sits on top of Android Marshmallow, offering a few bonus features and changes over last year's G4. The most irritating difference is the culling of the apps tray, which means that all of your apps are now sat on the home screens instead. Thankfully, this can easily be rectified though, just check out our G5 tips and tricks for that one. Besides that, it's pretty much business as usual, with some handy additions like an easy migrate tool for switching from your old phone. The LG G5 is one of the first phones we've seen packing Qualcomm's latest all-powerful Snapdragon 820 processor. This is one of the fastest mobile chipsets around right now, which in turn means that the G5 offers one of the smoothest experiences we've seen. You'll not notice any undue stuttering or other ill effects, even when running dozens of apps in the background and blasting your way through the latest demanding Android games. We're hoping that the G5 continues to perform well over the coming months, but right now it's no slouch. So the big whoop around the G5 is its modular functionality, but the fact that you can prise open the phone also means that you can replace the battery. To press a tiny subtle button near the bottom edge of the phone and that entire end can be peeled off, revealing the bright yellow cell inside. That's a quick and easy way to replenish your power. Otherwise, the G5 can be charged using a bundled Type-C USB cable. And of course, Quick Charge 3.0 is supported, one of the fastest charging techniques around right now. After the G5's modular design, its biggest talking point is definitely its dual-lens camera. Unlike previous dual-lens mobile snappers like the HTC One M8 and the recently launched Huawei P9, these two lenses are actually separate entities to be chosen between. One is a standard 16-megapixel snapper, capable of shooting photos packed with detail, while the other is an 8-megapixel wide-angle lens, perfect for group shots and vistas. We've already reviewed the G5's camera in great depth with photo samples and video samples, so you can check that out on Recombu.com. Even if you have no interest in LG's modular functionality, which is yet to prove itself worthwhile, the G5 is still well worth considering as your next full-time smartphone. The dual camera setup is brilliant, offering impressive flexibility, while performance is up there with the best. And in terms of media performance, the G5 again does its job, offering strong, striking visuals. This is also one of the few phones out there to offer a removable battery, to keep you going on those super long journeys. However, only time will tell if the G5 is simply a great flagship phone or an essential and innovative device that can be expanded and upgraded at the owner's behest. Hopefully you enjoyed this video on the LG G5, and if you have any questions about the phone, you can drop us a line down below in the comments, and you can read the full review, camera reviews and comparisons on recombu.com/mobile. Thanks for watching. Jesus.